Well met, Feudal Lords! With the relaunch of Life is Feudal MMO drawing ever closer, we're kicking off a new video series, the Dev Diaries, where we'll bring you all the latest and greatest from the game. So without further ado, let's dive right in. This spring, Life is Feudal MMO will make its big comeback on Steam. We know that Life is Feudal has a lot of diehard fans that have stuck around even after it shut down all those years ago, and that you all care about the game. So our first priority is to prove to you that we're here for the long run, and that we'll be working with you to make this game great. We'll start by being as open as possible with our plans, and by proving to you that we will listen to your input. Now, before we dive into what we've changed in the game, we really need to give a huge shout out of thanks to everyone in the community for the amazing help that you've given us. Without you, our work would have been impossible. What have we changed? Let's get the tricky topic out of the way first. Anti-cheat. If an MMO exists, people will try to cheat. Unfortunately, that's just a fact of gaming these days. To prevent this, we're adding the easy anti-cheat system to the game. Yes, we know that there's a love-hate relationship with anti-cheat engines in general, so we've spent a lot, and I mean a lot of time looking into what is available to us. We found that easy anti-cheat has the best player feedback, as well as the best potential to give you the most comfortable gaming experience. So, we've gone with that. With that out of the way, let's look at something a bit more fun, the game's balancing. You made it clear that both PvE and PvP needed a lot of fine-tuning. So here's a taste of what you can expect when we launch. Big improvements to skill leveling. Much better balanced weapons and attacks. Battles that are much more dynamic. 6 new buildings. Improvements to non-combat professions. A host of events and unique gifts ready for you to enjoy. And a lot of translation improvements. Don't worry, that was just a short summary of the changes. We've written up a detailed breakdown of all the improvements and changes, and you can find a link to that write-up in the video description. Wait, did you think that that was everything? We've not mentioned the introduction of the voice chat.
Anita Medic!
Yep, you heard correctly. Communicating in-game has just become a lot easier, thanks to the voice chat. Whether you want to simply chat to other players, coordinate your group's actions, or beg for mercy when you inevitably encounter PKers, yeah, good luck with that, you can do it directly from the game. Next, who remembers how carts of items would break at the server border? Or that delightful judgment hour clock showing the wrong time? Good times, right? Wrong. Those were two of the most frustrating bugs in the game. But worry not, we've squashed both of these bugs and many, many more. Again, a huge shout of thanks to everyone for helping us find and fix them. And that just about brings us to the end of this video. New buildings, new events, a lot of balance changes, bug fixes galore, and much more await you. The best part is, these are just a small part of our plans for the game, and we're really looking forward to diving into more details in the next video. So make sure to like and subscribe to us, turn on those notifications so you don't miss out on any of our future videos, and check out our social media platforms. Discord is the place to meet up with the community.